At the end of 2021, just as the lifting of COVID restrictions have begun to ease across the world, I asked friends, families, and strangers the following question. If you could go anywhere in the world right now, where would you go? London, Paris, Miami, New York. They say life is about the journey and not the destination. Yet, in our fast-paced world, we find ourselves speeding from one place to another, from one experience to another, all while the savoring of the journey makes its way to the back burner, at times forgotten, at times unknown. This is Giorgio. Named after Giovanni Giorgio Moroder, the father of disco music. You see, in the Land Rover community, the LR4, or Discovery as it's known around the world, is affectionately referred to as the disco. So, it was only fitting.
My name is Giovanni Giorgio, but everybody calls me Giorgio.
I thought about my travel question from earlier, and in each response there was a common theme present from just about everyone that I interviewed. And that was this: familiarity. Urban comforts and destinations already explored. Humans that have been kicked out of their comfort zone, desperately seeking a safe space once again. A desperation to return to an old normal, to offset our new normal. While the outcome of this pandemic will be studied for years to come, we can't ignore the physical and mental toll that it has taken on humanity and our Earth. To say that the last few years has been especially challenging would be a gross understatement. But it got me thinking, what would life be like if we intentionally challenged ourselves to live outside of our comfort zone all the time? To break our mold of normalcy? To unravel the self-induced societal complexities and simplify our presence and connection with the world around us? Would we be in a perpetual state of panic or awe? Fear or growth? In doubt or at peace with ourselves? And in fact, what is normal and who defines that? For myself, answers to these questions and more began to surface during my time with Giorgio. A roof over my head, a place to eat, sleep, stay clean, and stay warm. Giorgio was no longer just a car, but rather my home for the next few months. When we think about traveling great distances, we think about the destination, from home to airport to car to hotel to experience, and then all that in reverse for an encapsulated memory. We tend not to think about our experience here as a rolling sequence of happenstances, because compartmentalization is more palatable and programmed into us. My world was passing me by, and moreover, I was the one letting that happen. I had to make a conscious effort to undo the programming. Security became about simplicity and intimacy with my immediate surroundings. Learning how to care for myself and Giorgio when we were away from all of our creature comforts. Go too fast and you'll miss it. Go too slow and you'll miss everything else. Even off-road paths are faintly carved out by pioneers and like-minded individuals with a goal in mind of exploring our beautiful planet while returning to simplicity. It requires patience, respect, and a humble confidence. It also requires a level of understanding that things can and do go wrong, and we're responsible for how we react to these waves. Beautiful days can turn violent in an instant, and sometimes lead into terrifying nights. But just as the world continues on, so do we. Change is the only constant. When we learn to weather the bad, the good becomes that much better. Giorgio and I made a promise to one another. Take care of each other, and the possibilities will be endless. So we set out to make a reality of every challenge. We went from coast to coast, from sea level all the way to summits. We went to some of the most beautiful places four wheels could take us. And where 2 feet could take me. From thin-aired heights to turbulent depths. From in between narrow boulders to out in the middle of nowhere with just the elements beating down on us. Sometimes frightened, sometimes at peace, but always ready for the adventure ahead. No longer is the scent of familiarity the sillage of security. My comfort zone is in the unknown, in the challenges ahead, in the routes unexplored. And if we are to believe that humans and Earth are embodied with a soul, what can be said about a machine? The machine that is created through the exchange between the ingenuity of humans and the elements of the Earth. It too has a soul. One that is ripe for discovery, built for purpose, built for the unknown. Just like us.